Hello friends, welcome to another masterclass on the series of aviation. So today we'll be continuing our discussion about flying an aircraft. In my last video, I have discussed about three instruments which are used in flying an aircraft, and today we'll be continuing with some more instruments. So these are also some of the basic instruments that a pilot or somebody who is flying the aircraft needs to know. So starting with, first we'll discuss the concept. You know, Earth is generally considered as a huge magnet which is spinning in space surrounded by a magnetic field made up of invisible lines of flux. So Earth is a huge magnet. So Earth consists of the North and the South Pole. So as from the magnetic fields, we know that the magnetic lines of force starts from North Pole and they end up in South Pole, and these are circular in shape. So that is what it is written here. These lines leave the surface at the magnetic North Pole and re-enter the magnetic South Pole. This we know very much from our physics classes. So now there are two important characteristics of these lines of magnetic flux. So what are they? So whenever a small magnet is placed in the line of flux, then this magnet will rotate and it will align with these lines of force. This is one of the important concepts. That is, any magnet that is free to rotate will align with them. And the next is, an electric current is induced into any conductor that cuts across them, across these lines of magnetic flux. Then in that case, a small electric current is induced in a conductor. So here we are placing one conductor, then the electric current will be induced. So these three are the important characteristics of the lines of magnetic flux. So based on these concepts, we'll be studying further about our instruments. So one more important thing that we have to remember is, regardless of size, every magnet has two poles. This we also know. One is the North Pole and other is the South Pole. So what happens is, when two magnets are placed close to each other, and what happens if the North Pole of the magnet one is kept near the South Pole of the magnet two, then they will attract. And if the north pole of the magnet one is placed closer to the north pole of magnetic two, in that case they will repel. So this we know, that unlike poles attract each other and like poles repel. So this is also important concept of magnetic lines of force. So now we'll move ahead with our instruments. You know, you might have heard about the magnetic compass, which are generally used to know the directions like north, south, east and west. So normally a magnetic compass will show its alignment with respect to the north. So that is what a basic magnetic compass will show. Whereas in the aircraft, a magnetic compass shows the aircraft's heading related to the magnetic north. So this is a key concept to remember. And it is one of the basic instruments that is required for VFR as well as IFR. VFR is a visual flight rules, and IFR is the instrument flight rules. Just knowing the full forms is sufficient. We need not go much into the details of the IFR and VFR. So in aircraft also, a magnetic compass is used. But then the aircraft magnetic compass, it will consist of two small magnets attached to a metal float, which is sealed inside a bowl of clear compass fluid similar to a kerosene. So there will be a liquid which will be similar to kerosene. There will be two magnets in them, and there will be small needle. So this will comprise the magnetic compass of the aircraft. The magnets align with the Earth magnetic field, and so basically what the magnetic compass in the aircraft does is, the magnets, there are two magnets as we said, so these magnets will align with the Earth's magnetic field, and the pilot reads the direction on the scale opposite the lubber line. If you see the small white needle, so this is called a lubber line, and there will be indications like here N is represented, so this is the north. So if this needle is corresponding to this north, then that means the aircraft is flying exactly to the north. If your needle is showing somewhere with an angle relative to the north, then this is what the magnetic compass will show. It will show the relative angle to the north. In simpler terms, we can remember like this. So this needle will float corresponding to the north. So this way we'll know the angle with respect to the magnetic north. So this is what the magnetic compass does. So what happens with this is there are some errors that are induced in the aircraft's magnetic compass. This is because our Earth is always rotating. As you know, it rotates on its own axis, and because of its speed and also the aircraft speed, there are many errors that are induced in the magnetic compass. So some of them are, one of them is a variation. I think this is important, so that is why I'm going a bit depth of this. That is, a directions measured from the magnetic north poles are called two directions. Let's say this is the geographic north pole, and if we are measuring the angle with respect to the geographic north, then these are called the true directions. Whereas another is the magnetic north. So any direction which is measured with respect to the magnetic pole, this is called magnetic direction. These two are different concepts. One is a geographical north, other is the magnetic north. So any direction measured with respect to geographic north are called true direction, whereas any angle measured with respect to the magnetic north is magnetic directions. You know, north, geographic north doesn't always correspond to the magnetic north. It may not be always equal. This is a key term to remember. So what happens is, because of these two readings, sometimes there is a variation between the actual angle that is being we are getting in the aircraft. So this is known as a variation. So this is one of the errors in the magnetic compass. Similarly, there are other errors which I don't want to go into depth. Some of the deviation, dip errors, acceleration errors, and oscillation errors. So there will be a deviation of this magnetic needle which is present in the magnetic compass. There will be sometimes a dip acceleration of the aircraft, and due to oscillation of the needle, there are many errors induced. We need not go much into details, knowing these are sufficient. So this is an important instrument. Now moving ahead is a heading indicator. A heading indicator is a mechanical instrument designed to use to facilitate the use of magnetic compass. So it uses the magnetic compass. So as we have known that errors in the magnetic compass are numerous, like deviation, dip errors, acceleration errors, and oscillation errors. So in order to overcome them, what happens is a heading indicator is designed such that it is not affected with the forces that makes the magnetic compass difficult to interpret. So the heading indicator is designed such that the forces which are affecting the magnetic compass, those errors are reduced to minimum in the heading indicators. So the main concept that is used in the operation of heading indicator is the principle of rigidity in space. So this is the key term to remember. So how does it achieve it is, it uses a rotating gyro. This is the key term, that the heading indicator is a rotating gyro, which informs the pilot of an aircraft's direction, similar to magnetic compass. So heading indicator also uses a magnetic compass. Principle is same, but just that the mechanical construction of the heading indicator is different than the magnetic compass. Another one more important flight instrument is the attitude indicator. So the attitude indicator is also known as gyro horizon or artificial horizon. So it is also a flight instrument that informs the pilot the aircraft's location relative to Earth horizon. You might be knowing the Earth horizon. So this instrument shows the pilot its location relative, its orientation rather, with respect to the Earth horizon. If you see the diagram, it will be more clear. So this is how the instrument look like. So the, let's say Earth horizon is very horizontal. If the aircraft is even slightly bended, then this diagram will show a small tilt towards the left. So that is how the aircraft orientation relative to the Earth horizon is shown. And it is always shows in degrees. So what it consists of? It consists of a miniature aircraft. So this is what, if you see the small aircraft which is shown like this, and the horizontal bar displays a picture of the attitude of the aircraft. So this, if turns left or right, so with that we can know whether the aircraft is relative to the Earth's horizon. So this instrument gives an instantaneous indication of even the smallest change in the attitude. So even if the aircraft is slightly deviated from the Earth's horizon, then it will show the indication on the screen. Next, another important flight instrument is a turn coordinator. So turn coordinator will basically show the speed and the direction of the turn of the aircraft, as the name suggests. So it consists of basically two instruments. It senses rolling, yawning and turning movements. These are technical terms which I will discuss later in my next videos, maybe. The key, if you remember this diagram, that is more than sufficient. You know, it indicates the rate and the turn, rate and the direction and of the turn of the aircraft. So there is a needle that looks like an aeroplane and that rotates left or right. If you see from the diagram, it is very clear. So this aircraft diagram is basically a needle which turns left or right depending on the aircraft's turn. So the pilot will know by that the actual rate of turn of the aircraft and the direction by looking at this instrument. And another is, it uses a inclinometer, a black ball suspended in liquid that rolls right or left or remains in the middle depending on whether you're applying the correct amount of rudder during a turn. So if you see, there's a small ball. So this is what the ball is referring to. So this ball will also move left or right depending on the turn of the aircraft. So using this, the pilot will know the turn. So a small summary is, where the aircraft is flying, how you will know? You will know with respect with using a compass or a heading indicator. That is, it shows the movement of aircraft with respect to the north. So that is how the aircraft will know where it is heading. Second was the attitude indicator. So related to the earth horizon, it will show the indication. And the third is, whenever the aircraft is turning, how it will know. So it knows using the turn coordinator. So these are some of the important instruments that we have discussed. If you have any comments or suggestions you want me to include in my future videos, or you want to comment something on this video, please comment in the section. So if you have liked the video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos.